Good evening guys, I'm myself Vijay Kumar. I'm here to introduce you the word trigonometry. See, as you all know, the word trigonometry means tri means three, gono means angle, and metry means measurement. So you just, the trigonometry just means three angle measurement. It's just as simple as that. Hello guys, see, you all know about the introduction of trigonometry, so I just want to go up with the sum. So let's just read out the sum. See, in the trigonometry and the most of the chapters, you mainly read thoroughly the question that he has given. So let's just check out the question. The angle of elevation of a tower from the foot of a building is 30 degrees, and the angle of elevation of the top of the building from the foot of the tower is 60 degrees. What is the ratio of heights of tower and building? So he asked the ratio of heights of tower and building. Let the height of the tower equals to x, and let the height of the building equals to y. Okay, now see, let's just read the question again. The angle of elevation of the top of a tower from the foot of the building is 30 degrees. So let this be a tower, and now let this be the building. So angle of elevation of the top of a tower, the top of the tower from the foot of the building is 30 degrees. And the, what's the second one? The angle of elevation of the top of the building from the foot of the tower is 60 degrees. From the foot of the tower is 60 degrees. So let, we also need to assume the distance BZ. Okay, you got it? If this is the angle of elevation of a tower, and the 60 degrees is the angle of elevation of the building from the foot of the tower, so now the height of the tower will always be, this is the height of the tower, so we just need to establish the relation between this side and the height of the tower and height of the building, and we just need to establish this relation between the distance between the tower and the building and the height of the tower. So what we all have is, let's just take tan theta will always be the opposite side by adjacent side. So if we take this angle 30 degrees, if theta equals to 30 degrees, what will be the opposite side of this 30 degrees? It will gonna be x, and what will be the adjacent side of this 30 degrees? It will gonna be z. So what is tan 30 degrees? It will gonna be 1 by root 3. So equals to x by z. So that equals to x equals to z by root 3. So we just got the height of the tower as z by root 3. So all we just need to do is to find out the height of the building. Here we took theta equals to 30 degrees. So if this theta equals to 60 degrees, then it will going to be tan 60 degrees equals to. So what is the opposite side for this 60 degrees? Is going to be y. So y. And the adjacent side for the 60 degrees, it's going to be z. So the tan 60 degrees equals to root 3, that equals to y by z. So in order to find out the value of y, we're going to send the z to other side. So y equal to z root 3. So we got x equal to z by root 3 and y equal to z root 3. So what has been asked? What is the ratio of heights of tower and building? The first one is going to be tower and then the building. So we're going to write this height of the tower first as x is to y, that equals to z by root 3 is to z root 3. See, z is the common thing, so we're going to cancel it. So if you multiply both sides with root 3, we're going to get as simple terms as 1 is to 3. So the ratio of the heights of tower and building is going to be 1 is to 3. So this is as simple as that. So we don't need to get confused